Hello everyone, in this video we are going to do part 2 of the experiments with artists. So as you can see, I have opened the same thing which we had done in the previous video, that was part 1. This is part 2. So let's try out more things, huh? Don't know what's this mat for. I'll try more of these brushes. Let's try draw sticker. Oh nice. What other sticker this thing can draw? Oh wow, the sticker thing is really good, huh? Let's try everything but upside down. I don't know why. Anyway, it's a good button. Let's see what is where it goes. Okay. So we can set the length to something over here. So it's pretty good. I'll set the length to 100. Now see, very thick lines will come when I draw. Okay, now I'll draw a line and show you. And make the pattern original again. And then turn right. As I told in my previous video also, we always have to look at where the artist is looking. So he's looking this side, which is our back. I'll keep it 90 degrees to the right, so it's not left. For us it's to the left, but for the artist it's to the right. In some programs we have to make it in our only way. So now let's see how thick our line is. Let me see, I've not used this before. Oh, but the line is much thicker. I can set the width to 1000 and see. I think that length doesn't do anything to it. But it drew a kind of fun line. So that's how to change the thing. Now let me see, we have gone through functions. Let's see what this create a function means. Okay, name of your function. Draw. Curve line. Wait for just a second, everyone. Okay, so as I was saying, I'm going to create a command. So this I'm not going to tell you anything. So you have to just write the name of your function and what you want it to do. So I'm not going to tell you how to do it because this is for your own creativity. So I'll do the function now and you can relax. Okay, so in further videos I'll have to see how to make a function. So now I'm going to set side. I'm going to try to do things with everyone, because now I'm just going to experiment in this one. So then, I don't know what is this for and what is this comment one. But see, you remember this loops, now they're sometimes very good. Otherwise, one thing what you want to do 100 times, you can just do that thing once and then make it to repeat 100 times. And you know, in the play lab or the game lab, no, that time over there also you can get to, and there's one option in the loops that is repeat forever. So that is for making animations and all. Like in some of your video games, it might be one thing might be going up and down and throwing something at your player, and then you'll have to dodge it. So like that. So it's repeating forever. So always remember these brushes also. You can do many things with these brushes to make it look like some lightning bolts or normal thing. Or if you want to show love. I don't know why it's coming upside down. There must be some error. And waves. Rainbow colors. Bricks. So like this, if you set the pattern to bricks, you can make this like a wall. It's like a real drawing only, but just you're doing it virtually. Like this, like you can make this an animation also in play lab, game lab or something. So, and this looks like one of those stretch things. So I think we have explored the whole thing in artist. And over here also the same options on top to rename and all. So I'll see you in the next video where we'll be drawing something nice. I'll be making a video about game lab where we'll be making sprites and they will be the ones moving. So I'll explain you in the next video about that. Goodbye for now. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.